I would like to refer to a text message that has come on the page of Daily Mirror that says UPFA parliamentary group decides to nominate former President Mahinda Rajapaksa as opposition leader in parliament. Now I wish to ask, now the problem is whether the former president has become a former member of parliament. That's the issue now. So now this is a very critical question. Nothing personal against Honorable Rajapaksa, but the question is whether we are to call him Honorable Rajapaksa or Mr. Rajapaksa. Now the question is, Mr. Speaker, the issue remains to be, now we know our constitution says that the judicial power of the people shall be exercised by courts through parliament, except in the case of privileges and powers of parliament. Now the judicial power of the people is vested in this house, and now this is a matter that has been gone into and decided upon by this house and house alone, and therefore it is important for us to set up a select committee to go into this in detail to see whether this matter of fact is in fact true or not. Now I also know that Honorable Uday Gaman Pillai and Honorable Vasudeva Nanayakkara, being attorneys at law, has wrongly advised His Excellency the President and has unfortunately put Honorable Mahinda Rajapaksa into a serious trouble, right? Always giving wrong advice. So therefore, this issue has to be ascertained by this House, and therefore we have to await the determination. Once the select committee is appointed, let us go into this detail, because we have to examine examine the constitution of the UPFA, which is lodged with the Commissioner of Elections. We have to summon the Commissioner of Elections, ask him to produce a constitution, because we have the constitution. We have to produce a constitution and see whether who are the constituent parties of UPFA and how is the membership of the UPFA decided. Because UPFA is the party that contested the last parliament election. So, now also Article 99.13 is very clear. Only when a member is expelled from a party that they can go to courts within 1 month. Otherwise, ipso facto, immediately, once that member obtains membership from another party and his membership ceases, then his parliamentary seat also ceases immediately. Not to the expiration of 1 month. You see, so these are facts that we go into in detail, and that is why Standing Order 21, which talks about strangers in the House, though it can be raised and we can ask honourable members who are strangers to withdraw, we are not going to go that far.
Yeah.
We will await the determination of the select committee once it is appointed.
I look at that.